Hi, I'm Heather Lourcey, Westwood's head of school. Thank you for joining us this evening for our Schools Out community update. Tonight we will be talking about building community connections and why this is so important. We'll also cover the same usual topics like what's been happening at school, important upcoming dates, and parent resources. You may remember our community meeting topic from September. I probably have to give a prize if anyone actually does remember. Partnering to rekindle grace and courtesy. Our biggest focus this year has been reigniting grace and courtesy skills, helping students bring back kindness, courtesy, and respect for others. Respect, you know, is my top thing. It is respecting yourself, respecting others, and respecting property. So that is our goals. We'll continue working with these skills, of course, in the new school year. A study conducted last summer found that 81% of parents want schools to implement more activities to encourage and teach social skills. I think everyone knows that we've had kind of a downslide. Of course, that was no surprise to us. We knew intuitively because of COVID that our students missed out on everyday interactions with other students and teachers that would help them build social skills essential to success in life. It turns out that parents were feeling isolated as well. You know, everyone is craving more in-person interactions. We know that everyone's craving that with other families. So we've stepped up our community events for families and parents in a big way this past spring, and lots of plans for the upcoming fall semester. Let me ask, and you could put it in the chat. Of course, if you have any questions, you can go ahead and put those in the chat. Ms. Worthen is monitoring that for us, and when we get to questions and answers at the end, she'll let me know what questions you've had, and we'll try and get them all answered. But would also love to know what has been your favorite Westwood community event and why. So if you share your thoughts in the event box, that would be great. Community is one of Westwood's three pillars. For me, it's the most important pillar because community is the essential building block for the other two pillars, character and excellence. Being a part of a community is important to us in so many aspects of our life. Communities offer us physical and emotional support, as well as a sense of belonging. As parents, we wish we could be there for our kids, always. But of course, there's times when we can't and we have to let go. When we help our children to learn how to build positive community connections, like the ones that we intentionally incorporate into the classroom, we give them a gift for life. They build the skills to make community connections that support them physically and emotionally, even when we can't be there. At Westwood, we intentionally help our students develop community connections with students at all levels, as well as with teachers and staff. Example of that would be our house system. We know these connections are essential to shaping a child's identity and character, who they are, what they can become, and how they are essential to others. For example, secure and stable relationships with teachers and staff let our children know that there's someone else who can care for them when we're not around. This has a positive effect on their development and their sense of security. When children feel safe, they can focus their energy on learning. Research bears this out. A 2018 study found that when teachers deliberately fostered a sense of belonging by greeting each student at the door of the class, they see significant improvement in academic engaged time and reductions in disruptive behavior. So bringing back the welcoming handshake. We will definitely wash hands afterwards, but we're going to be bringing back the handshake in the mornings and the handshake when kids leave in the afternoon. Because it's such an important part of their relationship to their teachers and their identity in the class. Being a part of a community like Westwood also helps children develop their communication skills, grow their confidence and resilience, interact with each other, and develop lasting friendships. Our collective experience at Westwood has led us to encourage families to actively participate in our community. It is core to helping your child build community, character, and excellence. As with anything else, when we participate in our Westwood community and other communities, whatever community your family wants to participate in, we set a powerful and positive example for our children. I realize I'm probably singing to the choir. Numerous research studies find that the best indicator of a student's success in school is not income or social status. It is parents who participate in their children's education at school and in the community, create a home environment that encourages exploration and learning, and discuss high, of course not unrealistic, expectations for their children's achievements and future careers. So as I've said many, many times, parents are the ones, of course, who set the future for their child. And participating in your child's school is so very, very important. During our past online gatherings, you've probably heard me speak about the importance of students, parents, and teachers working together for success in the classroom. A big part of our secret sauce at Westwood is creating opportunities to have fun together and build community inside and outside the classroom. Some things we take for granted or maybe don't even know about, Westwood and its processes are designed to build community connections. So pretty much everything we do. We know you feel more a part of things when you can see what's going on every day. Probably some of you may or may not know, or you may just have guessed that Westwood used to actually be a warehouse with a very small office at the front. And so we got to design the way it was laid out. And so the way we designed it, the windows all line up with the outside and they all line up with each other from one class to the next. So parents can see in the classrooms, kids can see the parents in the hallways, teachers can see other teachers in the neighboring classrooms. Everyone basically feels a part of the larger whole. We're retrofitting the upper school to have the same feel. We've added windows to a couple of our classrooms and hope to do that in more. Of course, no more car line. I know that's in some ways sad because I do get the benefits of that, but also very joyful. Basically, toddler and primary and lower elementary families really need, we think, that time to meet each other, to feel secure, for a child to be brought to their classroom by their parent, for the parent to be able to, for you to be able to meet with your child's teacher and talk to them, just everyday small things that develop a relationship over time. Basically, this helps students to feel confident and cared for. It helps parents to build those relationships with teachers, staff, and other families that's so, so important. Now I'm going to share some of the ways we've built community at Westwood this past spring semester. It was very hard, you know, every one of these meetings we talk about extraordinary efforts. There's been a ton this spring, and it was very difficult to decide who might we showcase. And of course, thank you to everyone in our community for your ongoing efforts, small, large, and extraordinary. I can never really name all of them. But we would like to recognize Kim Worthen and Christy Abini for going way above and beyond the call of duty at the end of the school year. These ladies finished the Shakespeare play on Thursday. I don't remember exactly which Thursday it was, but a Thursday. They did set strike on the next day, Friday. They went home, packed on Saturday, and were at the airport at 6 a.m. for the seniors' Alps trip to New York Sunday morning. They spent sun up to way past sundown exploring the city. Their flight home was late Tuesday. Apparently, some weather issues. They got rerouted to Houston. They had to spend the night in Houston and then took a bus home on Wednesday from Houston to Dallas. That is real dedication. I remember not really thinking much through all of this and looking at the calendar and realizing that they were doing set strike on Friday and seeing that they had to pack on Saturday. And I was like, oh my gosh, I don't know how they did that. I'd also like to recognize Kelly Nelson, Natalie Avery, and our families who made Teacher Appreciation Week so extraordinary this year. I know the teachers absolutely loved everything. We received over 100 responses from students and their families when asked what they like about their teachers. Ms. Nelson and Ms. Avery typed up their answers on these little cards and then stapled them to the wall, special bulletin board, for the final day. So that was kind of the big surprise at the end of the week. And I know that I had some teachers who cried when they read some of the responses. There really was some beautiful things that were said, and it was very meaningful to them to have their work recognized and to be appreciated. I'd also like to recognize the Westwood staff for participating during staff meetings, shout outs. We've started a new shout out tradition. It's been great to hear some of the stories that I don't always get to see and to recognize each other's gifts and positive actions during these times. I guess I sometimes feel like it's my responsibility, but it's so fantastic when one teacher says something nice about a staff member or another teacher, recognizes them for things that they're doing. So I appreciate their help with that. Of course, congratulations to Westwood's most recent alumni who graduated on May 31st. This is an amazing group of young people, some who have been with us since they were in preschool and some arriving as late as the class sophomore year, but you would never know that. They're going to college literally from the Pacific Coast to the Atlantic Coast, big schools and small, studying everything from the arts to maths and science. We can't wait to hear about their adventures. We had some amazing speeches at graduation and promotion ceremonies, in case you didn't get to hear them. There was actually some teachers who did some great speeches too. There were some good laughs. But here's what some of the seniors commented on as being very important to them. I've met some of the best people one can meet here. And of course, Westwood will always be my home, and it will always be their home. Here's just a few events from the spring. So again, this is all talking about community and things that we do together. We had a second year of a toddler preschool and an elementary family picnic night on the playground. It's a lovely, very laid back evening to socialize, and we had fantastic weather. But to just get to eat a meal and walk around and talk to people, it was nice. The UE staff, Rachel Chatham, Pamela Fouch, and Kelly Short, presented a parent education event that focused on fostering independence at home. I heard that it was great. In honor of Earth Day, all the Proton campus kids worked in Westwood's gardens, prepping, planting, and watering. We've already had a beautiful red strawberry out in front. I say one red strawberry. Most likely the others were eaten by our neighborhood of animal friends, but cucumbers are growing and lots of flowers. And then all of the students attended end of the year school parties. At lower school, the traditional luau. I don't even know how that actually got started. That's one thing that I don't know if I could tell the story on how that got started. Probably somebody else knows. Snow cones, field days, bounce house, water balloons, and smash burger. You might not be aware, Westwood students have the opportunity to participate in the same activities that bigger schools have, the same activities we might remember from high school. We want to make sure that even though they're going to a small school, they get some of those big school experiences and the feelings that come from those. One activity is dances. So here you can see some dance pictures. I remember attending one middle school dance when I was in middle school. The girls stood on one side of the cafeteria and the boys on the other, and only very, very brave souls danced. At Westwood, the students own their dance. In middle school, they plan, decorate, do the purchasing, do the setup, and then after the dance, they do the cleanup. at one point or another, everyone dances. I remember noticing that kids I thought maybe wouldn't dance did. Every single student in the class dances. We ask and we encourage students to attend, even if just for an hour. Sometimes they don't want to, sometimes they're a little nervous, but we give them something to do. It's my fallback at a party. We ask them to maybe check in students at the door or maybe refresh the refreshments table. And then they're busy and useful, and they generally don't feel as awkward. So we really give them time to get to know one another and feel safe to be whoever they are. It's a really endearing thing. Westwood has a prom hosted for the seniors by the juniors. For many years, the prom has been held at the Dallas Petroleum Club. Parents come first and take photos. In the long line of photos, we used to take photos at the house, and then we'd meet at the park, and then go downtown and take photos. So it's a lot of photos. Then there's a dinner and a dance and cookies and milk at the end of the night. Cookies and milk is actually leftover from the upper elementary lock-in sleepover. As I've said before, kids love tradition, and who doesn't love cookies and milk? Students traveled all over the Metroplex for spring field trips. Field trips are a prime opportunity to practice grace and courtesy and become part of a community. Parents get to help chaperone. Kids get to pack a special field trip lunch, which means that they don't have to follow all the food guidelines. They should not go crazy and just bring a bag of candy, but they could have a piece of candy or maybe choose a soft drink in their sack lunch. They get to ride a bus, which I've often said is way bigger deal than actually going on the field trip itself. The bus is everything. So it's a very fun day. All LE students went to the Herd Museum, which has really developed over the years. I remember going to the Herd Museum way back when, and after hearing about the field trip, they have really added a lot of programs. Sounded like a lot of fun. They get to be outside and walk and run, and then they also get to have time to sit and listen and learn about something inside as well. Third graders read The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe, fantastic book, in class, and then they got to go and see the play just as a third grade class. UE students went to the Perot Museum. That's the field trip that I got to chaperone. We had a great time. And then the Dallas Symphony Orchestra later on in the spring. Two very different field trips, but both fun. Each spring, the juniors visit the SMU library. You see them here. As they begin preparing to write the International Baccalaureate Diploma Program Extended Essay. IB, the International Baccalaureate Program, uses an acronym for everything. So I'm going to try to start saying what they are so that everybody understands what I'm talking about. So International Baccalaureate is IB, Diploma Program is DP, and the Extended Essay is the EE. The SMU librarians work with the students with learning how to use a college library. The EE is a subject of the student's choice. So you can have a math EE, you can have a history, you could do something on literature, it could be all different kinds of things. In fact, that's the hardest part, picking one thing to study. The students form a thesis, and then they write a 4,000 word essay. Westwood students know how to write. Every single one of our students has written that 4,000 word essay, and they all do wonderfully well when they go off to college with any writing assignments that they might have. Of course, as previously mentioned, seniors also take their ALPS trip in the spring. As soon as their IB exams are complete, then they can fully relax and just enjoy New York City. Westwood's theater program is a great way for our students to connect with others, build confidence, learn project and time management skills, and then share what they've learned with the community. Golden Tickets, Oompa Loompas, Chocolate Rivers, and more. Our upper elementary student production of Willy Wonka Jr. was a blast. Songs that I remember from my childhood and I enjoyed very much seeing the kids do that. Our students put their hearts into designing sets, props, advertisements, memorizing lines and music, and all the other details that make shows unforgettable. Remember, this is not an after-school program for students who want to learn or just love to act. This production involves all of Westwood's UE students. It's quite a feat. This year's middle school Shakespeare production was a comedy of errors, which was coincidentally, or maybe not so much coincidentally, the first Shakespeare production directed 20 years again by Ms. Worthen and Ms. Avini. Our alumni created a beautiful tribute to the two teachers with two different slideshows, one commenting on their favorite Shakespeare memories, and then the other dancing the intro to Footloose, the shoe song at the beginning where they just show the feet moving for the dance. I actually saw alumni in their 30s, well into their 30s, dancing their hearts out, and it was it couldn't have been more sweet. The Abini sisters have created quite a theater legacy for us, and we couldn't be more grateful. When we celebrate milestones, we're also helping our students learn to build connections with their Westwood community, as well as other family and friend connections. Again, congratulations to the Westwood graduating class of 2022. In addition to senior graduation ceremonies, Westwood has a tradition of promotions. Earlier in the spring, students visit their new communities on Move Up Day. That day gives students the opportunity to see what will happen at the next level so they can look forward to it and not be so nervous. It's not so difficult to feel comfortable when a student goes to visit a new level because they see previous classmates, you know, kids that were kindergartners the year before are now first graders. And so when the kindergartners go visit, they see their friends and they're excited. They see familiar Montessori materials in the classroom. They see teachers that they see as they're going down the classroom or at some other community event. So it really helps them to feel good about the move. Of course, Move Up Day also adds to a bit of spring fever crazy. So as I say, it's always the good with the bad. But finally, promotion day comes. Students are promoted to their new levels, usually given a gift of some sort, and then perform a song for their parents. So we had a lovely time at both ceremonies. Here are some of the special ways we celebrated and built community connections in the spring. It was a great Donuts for Dad. Students invite their dad or special friend and start off the day with a donut. Of course, dads are different from moms. That's just the way it goes. I literally saw at least one wrestling match, and it was very, very loud, very different from the day we celebrate the special women in our lives, which is Muffins for Mom. The kids were all smiles and the moms had a wonderful time talking with the staff and children and the other moms. The spring auction gave us a chance to connect with other parents. Plus we raised $43,000 for the school while having a blast. Thank you to Kelly Nelson for making this year's auction a rousing success. Congratulations to our new auction chair for the 22-23 school year, Amanda McKinney. Amanda has a UE student walker. She will definitely need our support this next year, so I hope everyone will get behind her and sign up for the things she needs volunteers for and make next year as successful as well. We got a glimpse of what's in store for the next year at the PAWS sneak peek. PAWS will be hosting an international festival chaired by Shippa Mia in the fall. That is one of the most attended events at Westwood. And of course, Shippa will also need all of your talents to make this a successful event, especially since we're sharing our own heritages at this. And since I don't know about some of those things, we need everybody to chip in and show off their heritage and teach the children about it. This summer, we hope to have several smaller parties. I actually hosted a volunteer party in May. We had a lot of fun. And I will be hosting a senior party, a senior parent party in August. The Nelson family is hosting a first grade zoo day. It sounds like a lot of fun. If you have not gotten that invitation, please reach out to the office. You should have already received it. The Zabos have agreed to host a toddler parent event in December. The Dwouds will be hosting a fourth grade party in July. So if you have a child moving up to fourth grade, be looking for that invitation. And then if you'd be interested in hosting a party for a grade or a class, like I'd really like the middle schoolers to have a party. I would like for the ninth grade parents and kids to have a party. So if you're interested in doing any of those things, please let us know. Reach out to Ms. Nelson and we'll help you get started. I really think that it's a great start to a new class or a new level and getting to know parents at that same age with children of the same age. Our academic events are also designed to help our students build teamwork and community connections, of course, while building academic skills. There are some of these here are some of the students' academic achievements this spring. Each year, our upper school students participate in the National Spanish Examinations. About 40 Westwood Spanish students took the exam. Over 73,000 students took the exam nationwide. Of those, 9 Westwood students achieved special recognition. To put this in perspective, we're a small school, and 9 of the top awards went to Westwood students. This is a wonderful accomplishment and shows the excellence of our Spanish program here at Westwood. Our upper school Spanish teacher is Jennifer Hahn. So a shout out to Tara Myra Hudson, Shawnish Dobo, and Anna for honorable mentions, Sarah for a bronze medal, Haley for silver, and Anya, our gold medalist. Our third graders held their annual spelling bee that lasted an impressive 15 rounds. Congratulations to Danny for third place, Atticus second place, and Isaac for first place. The winning word, I'm going to get this wrong, was convivial. I don't use that word on a regular basis. It's an adjective that means friendly, lively, and enjoyable. A very fitting description for the third grade class. We want to congratulate them for working so hard throughout the year to get to this point. And then our upper elementary students held their annual science exhibit. Now, this is different from a science fair. Here, we're not looking to rank the students and give out prizes. We're looking for them to learn about something that they desire to learn about. This year was an open choice. Anything that they wanted to think about and learn about and discover was on the table. And then our younger students and the other students walk around and actually participate in this exhibition. Either the students explain to them what they learned, or they might actually get to do some of the experiments themselves and see how it works. So this is a real sharing of student to student. Westwood athletes started competing again this year. We had fall volleyball and cross country, winter basketball and cheer, and spring track and field. At upper school, we encourage students to participate in a school sport, and most of our kids do. The last few years have been different, but we hope that we'll get back to that percentage where almost every student participates in one of the school sports teams. There's so much to learn, but there's also the intangibles. Students building community with other private schools in our area and parents getting to know one another on the sidelines. Track's a good example for students because if you haven't been to one, track meets last all day long. But the events are pretty short. You know, I don't know, the average 400 meter race is under a minute, I think. So a student might be running in that race and maybe participating in some other aspect of the event. And then they have the whole rest of the day. So they walk around from tent to tent and visit with other schools and make friends, friends that they see every year at track. And then They notice them and see them on the soccer field or at the basketball game. And then of course, the volleyball and basketball games are fantastic for meeting other parents in the stands. So we hope that you'll join us for those things. The same benefits are evident at lower school. We will help parents form teams at this level. We need volunteer coaches. So if you're willing to do that, then we can have teams. And I think it's one of the best things for elementary students to have. As athletic director, Coach Lourcey said at a parent education, you don't need to have played college or even high school sports to coach elementary age kids. We will help you. This is a big initiative for the school this year. Please let us know if you want your child to play on a team. Signups are going to begin soon. And if you're willing to coach, we would really appreciate it. And I know that you'll get so much more out of it than what you think. We need more participants for upper school soccer this fall. We are getting close at both middle school and high school, but we need a few more students. Please let us know if your student can join, have them call, or you send us an email, whatever. We really want to see the kids getting back out on the soccer field this fall. Then we host an award ceremony in May. Lots of Westwood athletes received special awards for both their contributions on the field as well as their academics. Westwood girls track and field 4x4 went to state this year. Congratulations to Carla, Ava, Christina, and Frida. Let's see, these are great resume builders, of course. And don't forget, it's easier to join a middle school or a high school team when your child has some experience playing at the elementary level. All right, summer programs. We've kicked off summer fun last week. Shout out to Ms. Nelson. She's a busy woman for putting together a great Summer to Shine and Summer by Westwood lineup this year. We still have some spots open. You can see here which ones. One camp that I wanted to highlight is the academic math camp at upper school. If your child could use some assistance, or maybe they just love math and they're biting at the bit to get started on it, this is a fantastic opportunity. So I hope that we will have some students who will join us for that camp. All right, key dates. Tomorrow is uniform try-ons. If you can come by between 2 and 5, please do. Ms. Worthen will also be on site to answer all your questions. She is our uniform guru. She's done it all, so she knows all the ins and outs of uniforms. So hopefully you can come. If you can't and you have questions, of course, please just call, ask your questions. We'll get them answered for you. Upper school athletes need their physicals complete by August 1st to start fall practice. That is not as far away as it seems. I know doctor's appointments can be difficult to come by, but you can also go to a standalone facility. Many offer back to school physicals at a very reasonable price, places like a Care Now, that type of place. So please make sure that your child gets their physical done so they can start practice on time and we can get ready for the fall season. Then mark your calendar for the back to school bash. After school studios will be on hand, uniform resale, hot lunch signups, etc. There is a new format on the school calendar. We've had a meeting. We are really working hard to communicate better. So we're including as much as information as possible in the calendar. So parents can look at the athletic calendar and the school calendar. And then if you hit on those, additional information's provided. So we're trying to answer the questions, who, what, where, when, why, and how, if we need to. So if you go to the Back to School Bash, you'll see there's all kinds of information on the calendar if you open that event up. And then there's also a flyer. So hopefully it will give you some more information. If there's a question that we haven't answered, please call and ask. If something isn't answered and it or it didn't make sense to you, then that's likely happening to another person as well. And we can add additional information. So please help us with that. If something doesn't make sense, please give us a call and then we can work on that. If you want to meet any or all of your child's teachers for the new school year, we hope you can attend the Meet the Teacher event. Let's see, don't forget, I'm just adding this in here, the morning coffees with me. We will announce those dates as soon as we decide when we want to do them. I haven't had that conversation yet, but we're gonna have them once a month. And so at the first meeting, we'll talk about September events. These only go through the Alps trip, let's say, but there'll be more on the calendar. And so we'll talk about all those events. We'll probably talk about homework. That's always a good August, September discussion point, and then answer any questions that you have. In the past, when we started these in May, we had some great parent conversations, all spurred on by their questions. I want to reaffirm that your child's physical and emotional safety is the top priority at Westwood. We can assure our families that preparing for emergencies and promoting a safe learning environment for our students is ongoing at Westwood. We have worked closely with local agencies to ensure that we are ready for any possible occurrences, including hardwired emergency response systems, special staff training, and other safety precautions and procedures to protect the well-being of our students and staff. Unfortunately, depression, anxiety, and even suicidal thoughts are on the rise among young people. It's little wonder with the almost daily violence in the news. Technology is a major culprit. Our kids see way too much and know way too much. I want to encourage anyone to feel safe in notifying the school of anything that may need to be addressed. That goes for parents, staff, and students. We are fortunate to belong to a small, tight-knit community where everyone is known. It's a real advantage for us. When problems or situations arise, we can help, and we do help. Nothing is ignored. And we're very blessed to have someone who is qualified to deal with issues in Ms. Rezakani, our licensed professional counselor, who works with our students during the school year. So if you need anything over the summer months, please call the Lower School office and one of our administrators will connect you with someone who can help. Westwood has been in full in our primary classes, our preschool classes, for a few years. And so we've decided that expanding our preschool program into a fourth classroom will be a great benefit to our community. We're currently reviewing candidates to round out our preschool team of teachers. And of course, we have some constructions of new rooms happening. When does Westwood not have construction over the summer for new rooms? Always. We're very excited for what the new school year is going to bring us. Our three-year-old through kindergarten classrooms set the stage for future of a student's Montessori education. A unique aspect of Montessori classrooms is the three-year cycle that allows the youngest in the classroom to learn from the oldest. But more dramatically, the kindergarten student becomes the leaders as they set the example that the three- and four-year-old students will follow. This open sharing of knowledge from being the beginner to the experts of the classroom creates an environment for continued growth throughout the three-year cycle. Students then enter their elementary years with this foundation of collaboration and community and confidence for success. It's one of the things that I love most about Montessori. At Westwood, what we previously referred to as preschool includes kindergarten. So three-year-olds, four-year-olds, and five-year-olds in their kindergarten year. Developmentally, that's the appropriate break between the kindergarten year and the first grade year. So developmentally, there's a stage between ages 3 to 5 or 6, and then 6 to 9, and then 9 to 12, and so on. So we've decided because there's some confusion around that and the kindergarten year and what does that mean in Montessori, that we're going to start calling our preschool classrooms primary classrooms. That's because Montessori has a different way of saying things, and a primary more accurately describes that three-year cycle. So not only are we going to have the confusion of adding a preschool classroom, so preschool two is going to become preschool three and preschool three is going to become preschool four, we're going to also call them primary classrooms. So we'll have primary one, primary two, primary three, and primary four. Ways to share the gift of Westwood. You could write a review in niche.com. It's one of the best ways you can help new families discover our school and understand what it's really like. As an added bonus, the company is offering, if you write a review before June 30th of your school, you'll be entered to win $1,000 for sharing your story. So that's great. And then of course, invite a friend, take a personal tour with Mr. Regini, or invite a friend to a community event to share our community firsthand. A few items to remember for summer. We need to balance rest, fun, and learning. If your student is already in elementary or upper school, there's a summer packet of schoolwork. If your child has misplaced the work, call the school office and we can direct you to where they are. Online, they're all online for everybody, so it's no big deal. Of course, you need to stay safe, reminding children about heat exhaustion. That's already happened at my house, even when one of my sons was in the pool all day, still had some heat exhaustion. So you have to be careful about that. Make sure that your kids have some time off of their cell phones and that you're monitoring those, of course. Obviously need to be aware of the 4th of July and fireworks. Thinking about the safety aspect of summer. We want to have fun, but we want to be safe, right? I always also say that while I do believe students should do some academic work, like just reading, which is academic work, let them pick out what they want to read and have them read. They do also need to rest. So they shouldn't do work during their vacation. So vacation's vacation, and then a regular summer day might be reading a chapter or doing a math page, doing some chores for sure, and then just enjoying the rest of the day. All right, we have our usual resources for parents. Parental participation, that one of the things that we talked about, parental involvement is key to student success. I wholeheartedly believe that. Handling scary news, some of the things we've seen in the news. Both of these articles came from a parent for me, and I appreciate that. Helping children cope with frightening news, and how to talk with your kids about school shootings. And then preventing the summer slide, which we call that academic slide that sometimes happens if we don't do any work over the summer. So there's a couple of articles that we shared last summer. And all of these resources are located online under, let's see, resources parents can use now. So. If you go to our website, you can find that and find all of these articles that we've always put up at the end of our community meetings. Okay, questions and answers.